We're going to talk about the histogram here in the develop module. And the histogram's up here in the top right. There's some good information here right with it. It tells me the ISO, it tells me the focal length of the lens, it tells me the aperture, it tells me the shutter speed here. Now, the way you read a histogram is the left is blacks. And so if I put my mouse right in here, you'll see it says blacks. Then we have shadows, then we have exposure, and then we have highlights, and then we have whites. And you see all the little columns are lighting up as I go through here. So that gives me some good info. Another thing that it tells me is that I've got this little triangle here, and that triangle, when it was red, is telling me that there's what's called a clipping warning. So when I did that, you might notice that in some of these shiny metal parts, there is red showing up, and that red tells me that that is pure white. That is gonna be the white of the paper. If I print, it's showing me where those specular highlights are. Now, you have to ask yourself a question. Should you have pure white? If you have a specular highlight like I do on the metal here, probably at pure white's okay. If you shouldn't have pure white, then you probably need to adjust this and lower down your whites here. So I'll show you how this works, but this one actually looks pretty good here. So I take this white slider and I'll just make it go left, and I'm taking those down. And if I can't quite get it to work, then maybe I should try the highlights, and I made it go away that way. So you can kind of do a before and after and compare the two. So you can see nothing really changed other than the whites for the most part. Now there's a little bit of the bright areas in the background that you can see have changed as well, because it changes the whole image. So there's a way to do this just for certain parts. But you can kind of see the one on the right has no true specular highlights. The one on the left still does. It has pure white in those areas that show up red. And if I turn off the clipping, you can kind of just see it without. So again, here's a different way to look at it before, after. So there's a little bit of dulling down. Now, I don't think I necessarily need to do that in this image. So what I'm gonna do real quickly is I'm gonna go Command Z, and I'm gonna reset that. There we go. And I've got that sort of saved there back to where it was. Now, another thing I can look at in the histogram is my blacks. So I'll put my mouse over the left, and those areas that are showing up blue, now those are pure black. So ask yourself, should you have pure black in those shadows? And if you should, that's great. If you wanted more detail, you might want to lighten those up. Now, there's a couple ways I could do that. I could move the black slider and take it down a little bit more. That's one possibility. I could also move the shadow slider. Now, on something like this, probably a little bit of pure black in there is a good thing. So I'm not going to change it too much. But you might see that now I've got more texture and sort of that leather casing on the camera than I had before. And that's a good way to read the histogram. In general, what you want to do with the histogram is make sure you have no gaps. You want to have information all the way across on the histogram. Another thing is when you have a good overall white balance, you should see a big chunk of gray going across the center here. There might be little peaks of color, but you'll notice that the front is gray, and that means that this has been really well color balanced.